We have spoken about subqueries for quite a bit, but there is one last topic I want to give you around the world of subqueries. The last topic we're going to discuss here is something called a correlated subquery. To understand what a correlated subquery is, we're going to try to solve another little problem. Now, when you first look at this problem, it's going to sound rather easy to solve. But the more you look at it, the more you realize that it is a little bit challenging. So our goal is to show the name, department, and price of the most expensive product in each department. That is the goal. Let's first kind of walk through this imaginary data set and just make sure that we really understand what we're trying to do. So we would probably want to find all the unique departments to get started. In this case, it looks like the only departments we have are industrial, outdoors, and grocery. All the others are repeats of those same departments. So we would then look at each department one at a time. We'd start off first with industrial, and then we would try to find the most expensive product. So we would compare 876 versus 328 versus 796. Well, the first one is definitely the most expensive, so we would drop those two rows right there, and we have now processed the department industrial. Next up would be outdoors. So we've got outdoors at 412 versus 298. Well, we definitely keep around the 412. And then finally grocery at 10 versus 989. And we would stick around with just 989. So that is what we are going for. We only want to see each department one time, and we want to see the product with the most or the greatest price. All right, now that we understand what we're going for, let's imagine how we would write this out using a subquery. Now that we know what we are going for, let's try to write out a quick subquery. The subquery is not going to be what we are going to eventually end up with, but I just want to put something together so we can start off some discussion about exactly what a correlated subquery is. So I'm going to write in a subquery for right now that is going to select the maximum price from products where the department is equal to industrial. So notice right now that I've got a hard-coded department inside of here. So this is not extremely useful, because eventually we want to see each department, not just industrial. Nonetheless, let's just take a look at what is going to happen if we make use of this subquery for right now. Before we do, however, one other quick reminder on how the where clause works in general. So when we think about from and where, the goal of from is to get some number of rows for us to somehow iterate over or fetch. All those different rows are then fed into where. Where is going to be executed one time for each row. So if we think about just the outside query for right now, we would imagine that first we have this row right here come in, and the where gets executed. After that, we then move on to the second row. That's going to come in, the where gets executed. Then on to the third row, where gets executed, and so on, you get the idea. Now here's the real catch when we start using a subquery. When we make use of a subquery, as soon as we get a row inside of this where right here, the subquery is then going to execute, and it's going to be executed, you can kind of imagine, in the context of this row right here. When the subquery gets executed, it itself might fetch some number of rows and then execute a where for every single one. So in other words, when we are executing a where for just this row right here, we can imagine that the following thing occurs. The subquery runs, we get all of the different rows for products, and then we execute the where for every row that we just fetched. So likewise, just like we just saw with the outer query, the subquery is going to first take a look at that row, execute the where, and then this one, and execute the where, and then the next one, and so on. So you can kind of imagine that this is like a double nested for loop, if you are familiar with a for loop in general. For every row that we're going to iterate over on the outer query, we're going to iterate over all of our different products on the inner query. So it's kind of like a nested for loop. So that is one thing I just want you to keep in your mind for right now. Now we're going to kind of up the complexity here just a little bit. Hopefully that part is clear enough. So I'm going to add in just a little bit of complexity here. I'm going to make a little change to both of these queries. On the outer query, I'm going to tag the from right here with an alias. So we're going to say from products as P1. Remember, by adding in an alias, we can now refer to P1 anywhere inside this query. For example, I could put in P1.price. Now that is not strictly required. We do not have to put in p1.price. But if we do, it's just being very clear and explicit that we are talking about a row from this products table. We're talking about a row that we fetched while executing this from right here. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to add an alias over on the subquery as well. Right after products, I'm going to put in as p2. I could then mark department right here as p2.department. So likewise, this is not required. We are just being very explicit and saying that we are talking about a row from the p2 dataset. And in particular, we are trying to refer to the department property on that row. So if we really think about what p1.price and p2.department are doing right now, p1.price is really talking about that cell right there, like this value. And p2.department is really talking about this value. So it's very clear that we can kind of refer to very distinct rows and very distinct columns, like really distinct cells is what I mean to say here, or distinct values, by making use of these aliases. Okay, so now here is the final jump. The last thing we really need to understand what a correlated query is. Remember, we treat this, or we can think of this as being like a double nested for loop. So while the subquery is being executed and we are looping over a bunch of rows, we still have this kind of P1 row out here, like this row right here. And here's the big part. We can refer to values inside of this row on the subquery. So inside of the subquery, we can refer to different values from this outer row. For example, instead of saying p2.department equals industrial, we could instead say p1.department right there. Now think about what this is going to do. First, the outer query is going to execute. We're going to get all the rows from products. We're then going to start to execute this where for the very first row inside that data set. So it's this row right here. When we start to execute the where, we're then going to run the subquery. The subquery is going to go and get many rows from products as well. It's going to tag all those rows as p2. It's then going to pick the first row off the list and execute the where for that one as well. So at this point in time, we've got the first row right here and the first row right here. And we can refer to values from both of these rows inside that where. So in this case, we are saying that we only want to hold around this first row right here if its department is equal to the department of this row over here. If those are equal to each other, then we are going to hold onto that row on the subquery. We're then going to move on to the next one. That'd be the second row right here. And then we would repeat the process. So now the P2 is referring to this row, and P1 is still referring to this row. Because remember, for every row in the outer query, we're going to go through many, many rows on the inner query. Now we're going to take a look at the P2 department, which is outdoors, and see if it is equal to P1 department, which is industrial. In this case, it is not equal, so we're going to discard that row altogether. We're then going to repeat this process. We go on to row 3. Is grocery equal to industrial? Nope. We're going to dump it. How about for 4? Is industrial equal to industrial? Yes, it is. So we're going to keep it. There we go. And now just one last row right here. Industrial is equal to industrial, so we're going to keep it. So we have now built up a set of rows. We have filtered over everything in products for right now. We applied where to every one of those rows. And now out of all the rows we have remaining, we're going to find the max price. So in this case, the max price is 876 right there. So the value 876 is what comes out of this subquery for this very first row. Just this first one by itself. We get back 876. So now, all we have to do is apply some kind of operator right here that's going to decide whether or not we want to hold on to this row. So we're going to say if P1's price is equal to the max value that just came out of the subquery, then let's hold on to this row. Well, in this case, 876 is equal to 876, so we're going to hold on to that row. All right, so now, hopefully that part, I know I went over it in very long, very great detail, but we're going to repeat this process for just one other row. So this entire process, everything we just went through, is going to occur for row 1, 2, 3, blah, 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 all the way through. Let's skip on to row 4, however. So this is when we process row 4 on the outer query. So we're looking at row 4. We're going to apply the where to it. So we're going to take a look at row 4. And once again, for row 4, we're going to run this entire subquery, which might involve many different rows in its own right. Let me get a copy of row 4 very quickly back up here. There we go. So for row 4 right here, we're then going to execute the subquery. Once again, we're going to take a look at all the different rows from products, so all these different rows, and for each one, we're going to evaluate where p2.department equals to p1.department. So we'll start off right here with row 1, and we'll check to see if industrial is equal to industrial. Yes, it is. So we're going to hold on to it. We're going to take a look at the second row. Outdoors, nope, doesn't matter, don't care about it. Grocery, nope, not the right department, don't care about it. And then we finally get on to industrial once again. Okay, this is industrial equal to industrial, so we're going to hold onto that row. And then the next one, industrial equal industrial, so we're going to hold on to that one. And then we're going to repeat that process for all the rest of the rows, and that concludes the where. We have retrieved all of our rows, we applied the where, we did some filtering, and this is what we came up with. So now out of these remaining records, we're going to run max price. What is the max price? Once again, it is 876. So from this overall subquery, we return just the value 876. It's going to flow back over here. And we're going to check and see if this row's price is equal to 876. Nope, it is not. It is not equal. So we are not going to include that row in our result set. So what is the impact of these two flows we just went through? We just went through a flow for row 1 and row 4. Well, the result of these two flows is that we ended up getting the max price inside of industrial, and we discarded another record inside of industrial that was not the max price. So this is how we would solve this overall query. We can imagine that the same process is also going to happen for, say, outdoors. We can imagine, I'm just going to show you just one more example very quickly here. So for row 2 right here, we would process the where with row 2. And once again, that means that we're going to run this entire subquery. So we'd take a look at row 1. Do they have the same department? Nope. So I'm going to drop row 1. We'd take a look at row 2. Do they have the same department? Yep. So I'm going to hold on to that one inside the subquery. Let's go to row 3. Different departments. Doesn't matter. Let's go down to row 7 because that's the only one that does matter. Same department, they are both outdoors, so I'm going to hold on to it. So now out of these remaining records, I'm going to find the max price. It is 412. That's what's going to be returned from the overall subquery. So that's going to go back here, and we're going to check and see if P1's price is equal to 412. Yes, it is. So we're going to hold on to that record right there. And once again, that's going to give us now the max value or the highest priced product out of the outdoors category. Even if we ran the same process for some other outdoor value like this one right here, the 298, we would not include this 298 value because it does not have a price equal to the 412. Only the original row 2 does right here. Okay, so that is going very far into detail, and I apologize for the length of this video. But now that we've discussed this entire process in great, great detail, let's go and write out the final query to solve this. Okay, so back over here, I'm going to select name, department, and price from products, and then we're going to do our where. We're going to apply an alias to products right here. We're going to call it P1. And then inside the where, we're going to take a look at the P1 row and ask if its price is equal to a single value that is going to come out of a subquery. And the single value that we're going to calculate here is going to come from select max price from products where, and then once again, we're going to mark the from with an alias, so as P2. And then our condition in the subquery, we only want to take a look at rows where the P1, so that is the outer row, the outer department is equal to the inner. department. So I only care about departments identical to the row that we are currently iterating over on the outer query. If they are the same, then we want to include that in our result set. Then out of all the rows we include in the result set, find the maximum price, and then this entire subquery for one individual row is going to reduce down to a value of something like 915. And so we're going to check and see if the P1 price is equal to 915. If it is, great, we're going to include that in the results of the overall query. Okay, so let's run this. And there we go. We should now see each department listed exactly one time, and each record should be the most expensive product inside that category. Let's pick one out at random here. How about the very first one, outdoors? It has a price of 412. I should not see any other results of outdoors. So if I do a find on this page, I don't see any other results for outdoors. And if I replace this with a select star from products where department equals outdoors, I should not see any other products with a price greater than 412. We're going to run that, and sure enough, 412 is the most expensive product. All right, so that is a correlated subquery. The term correlated subquery essentially means that we are referring to some row from the outside query in the inner query or in the subquery. We refer to a row in the subquery by applying an alias somewhere, and then we can freely refer to that alias inside the subquery. All right, one more time. I apologize for the very long video here. I hope it was not too boring. Let's take a look at one more example of a correlated subquery in the next video. I promise it will go a lot faster.